My name's Justin Freeman. I'm the Vice President of Carbon Capture, Utilization, and Storage, and Hydrogen for Coffman Engineers. Carbon capture, a lot of it is focused on, you know, preventing the CO2 from going out the flue gas stack. And there's a couple different ways that you can do that. But in general, a lot of it is called post-combustion capture. There is some things like oxy-combustion or pre-combustion. But really, the simplest version is you're trying to concentrate that CO2 to really high purity, like 95 to 99%. It's transported generally to geological storage. There's a lot of power plants in the United States to date, right? And so as you think about, is it better to switch over to renewables? You know, is there an opportunity for those existing plants to serve as baseload power? And with the intermittency of the renewables, baseload power is really important. And what's the cheapest pathway that we can really decarbonize those existing assets that we have as a society? And so as you look through the lens of energy security at a regional level, at a country level, there's different resource bases that people have, whether that's wind potential, solar potential, or they might be, you know, blessed with hydrocarbons. And so, you know, to enable those hydrocarbon developments to still happen, we really need some tools like CCUS. In the future, what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to actually do negative carbon sequestration. And so direct air capture is one of those examples where you're seeing some projects being announced where they're literally sucking the atmospheric CO2 that's at about 420 parts per million, concentrating that to a very high purity CO2, like 99%, and then geologically sequestering that. So the benefit of geological storage of CO2 is you have that confidence that you're not basically doing carbon offsets for tens or hundreds of years. You're doing carbon sequestration for millions of years. Carbon capture is going to be a really important tool set that we have in the energy transition. The energy transition, you know, is really about taking the energy system that we have today and really taking that to a lower carbon energy system in the future. And carbon capture is a great way for us to make more immediate impact today. It also helps those countries that have natural resources to develop them and still realize the benefit of that, but do it in a way that is lower carbon.